Hello guys, welcome back to my channel Funix Creation. So in today's video I'm gonna show you how you can DIY this mini computer with cardboard, and it's on a special request and special demand of one of my very dear subscriber. So here it is. So for this you'll need cardboard, paints, glue, paper clay. So let's get started. So over here, as you can see, I've taken this cardboard cutout in the shape of this, and I'll just draw some border line for the frame, and I'll just chop it off and then cover this with a plain white paper. So after covering this, I'll just take another white cardboard and I'll just attach it on the back side of this frame. So this will create a monitor screen. Then this is the cardboard stripe and it's a thick cardboard, and I'll just make a hole in the middle part in the center. So the hole is now made, and these are two tiny pieces out of cardboard circle, and one has the hole completely inside it and the other one has the hole only in the half part. And then I'll just attach that with a plastic straw. And then I'll just attach this over here. So this is a thing which will help the monitor to move. Now I'll just attach it over here on this part, the monitor screen, and make sure this part remains in the center. And then this will be the border line. So once it's done, it's looking something like this. Now this is another cardboard piece which I'll just fold it and make it into a cylindrical shape. Then I'll just use the hot glue gun and stick the second part, the second circle which has the complete hole inside it. I'll just stick that, and then these are some more cutouts out of cardboard. You can see the size and the shape, and then I'll just attach them together like this. So this will create the monitor back, the body of the monitor, and I'll just cover it like this. So this will be the full frame. So once it's done, I'll just attach these two parts together. Now I'll just close the back side of this using another cardboard piece. Now these are two circles. For the base of the monitor, I'll just stick them together and make sure you have thick cardboard for this. So this will be able to take the full, you know, the heavy weight of the monitor. So now I'll just stick that part over here and then insert the straw. So as you can see, it's easily movable. The monitor can move now like this. Now I've taken these two cutouts out of cardboard again and this stripe. So I'll just use the hot glue gun and attach them together. So guys, you must be wondering what I'm making right now. So let me tell you, this is the CPU. And I'll just do this and make this. Now over here I've taken these tiny pieces, different pieces, and I'll just attach them together over here on the front part of the CPU. So this has a tiny line hole that will be on the bottom side. And then another part over here. Then this one. So you can see the shapes which I've made. You also have to make that shape only. And then you'll just take some black paper. I've taken a black paper over here and I'll just insert it on the back side so that it can show the dark side when you see in from the front, and the tiny stripe over here of the black paper. Then this is a white cardboard and it's not too thick, so I'll just make this CD drive. I'll just insert this tiny piece of cardboard over here, and then I'll just cover the edges like this. And and this is the CD which I've made out of a silver cardboard. And now I'll just cover this complete part in a black sheet of paper. And then I'll just take the CD over here. And I'll just cover this using a white card paper or cardboard. So now I'll just insert it and see the end point of this. And then over there I'll just attach a tiny piece of cardboard which will help it to stop the CD drive and not let it fall. Now this is another cardboard piece which I've covered with white paper and I've made a circle. And then this is another cardboard, white cardboard, in which I've just punched few holes, tiny holes, and I'll just attach it over here. So this will be the speaker and also the breathing space for the CPU. And now I'll just cover the part over here using that cardboard. Now for the CD drive to open, I'll just take a tiny piece of wire and I'll just insert it in the middle. Now I'll just take a white pearl bead and attach it over here. So this will be the handle. And now for the base, I'll just take two pieces of cardboard and I'll put it over here on two sides. So as you can see, this is CPU is also done. These two parts have now been completed. Now for the keyboard, I'll just take a cardboard cutout over here, like in this shape, and I'll just cover it completely with paper clay. If you don't know how to make this, I'll mention a link in the description box below. Make sure you check it out. And then I'll just take my sculpting tools and make some keys for the keyboard. Make sure you do this before it gets dried. So once it's dried, as you can see, it's hardened enough. Now I'll just take my sandpaper and I'll just, you know, brush the ends to smoothen out. Now I'll just take this, you know, some more paper clay and make a tiny mouse and then punch holes inside them. Now I'll just take my paper clay and smoothen out the edges. I'll just hide the cardboard and then smoothen out the edges like this. So once it's done and it's dried enough, now I'll just scrub it off again using some sandpaper. And make sure you use the most thinnest sandpaper so that it won't scrub off the more, you know, paper clay. So I've taken the thinnest sandpaper over here and I'll just use light hands to scrub it off. So now for the CPU also. Likewise, I'll just scrub off the remaining and excess paper clay from all of them, and then they will almost be smoothened out like this. So now these are two pieces of paper clay. I'll just take that and punch holes inside the CPU and then use glue to attach them so it will get secured even more properly. And some more on the monitor also. So these will be the buttons and the light indicators. Now these are some tiny thin pieces of card paper and I'll just use some stripe out of here and then cover the CPU to get them more detailing. And then I'll just chop off the excess part. Now I'll just start painting it. You can use any paint. Three options are there. You can either use white, black or grey. So over here I'm just going with grey. I know on the screen it looks a little slightly blue effect, but no guys, it's grey and I'm painting grey acrylic paint over here for the monitor. So firstly I'll just paint the body of the monitor like this. And then I'll just paint the front part also. Make sure you paint it clean. And now for the stand also, I'll just paint it that also in the gray shade. Then for the monitor, I'll just paint that also gray, because it's a complete set, so it will be painted accordingly. Now I'll just carefully paint the paint on the front side of the CPU so that it won't hide any of the detailings. And plus there's a CD drive also, so I'll just paint that also. Now these buttons will be painted with white acrylic paint on the monitor also and on the CPU also. And this is the LED light, so I'll just paint it orange. And over here also I'll just paint that also orange. Now for the inside part, I'll just go with a slightly dark effect, and then I'll just paint the keyboard also with gray paint. Okay, after painting the keyboard, I'll just take a light paint and just highlight the keys. And then I'll just use some black paper stripes over here for the border of the CPU, and also I'll just paint some white alphabets on the keyboard, tiniest alphabets. And this is the cardboard base for my set of computer. Now I'll just attach them using hot glue gun. You just have to see the perfect position, and then you have to attach them together. So over here I'll just use the CPU also for the decoration, and then the keyboard. But before that, the holes which we made earlier, I'll just use the tiniest and thinnest headphone wire, and I'll just use the hole and insert it in the mouse and in the keyboard. So this is a black headphone wire and it's very thin, so it will relate. And then I'll just take that. So as you can see, this is done. Oh shit, I forgot, I have to paint the screen also. So over here I'll just paint it with a slightly blue effect in for the screen. And you can also use some printouts over here. And sorry guys, it was looking so pretty adorable that I just couldn't stop myself from playing with this. As you can see, it's me playing with the mini computer which I've made. So just ignore that. And this is the final look guys. I'm just impressed with how it turned out. Trust me, it was looking super adorable for me. So this is the final look guys. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, and make sure you hit the bell icon so that whenever I post a new video, you will be notified. Till next time, bye bye.